here we are driving along the beach in Washington. They treat this as a highway here. Go for those people. Here. Driving.
This is sort of like that Fern Canyon.
Yeah. Nice little waterway down there. Nice trail it went along. Let's go. You know what? Battery. Here, four different trees put together here. That's a Sitka spruce. What did you say about the Sitka spruce?
The existence of this tree marks the range of the Northwest temperate rainforest.
And next to it, and beyond it, there is a western red cedar, was it?
Uh-huh.
See the furrowed vertical aspects to the bark.
Can they be over 1,000 years?
And then the next one over here is a Doug fir, a really big one. And pretty deeply furrowed bark here. And then next to that one is a hemlock, right?
Western hemlock.
Western hemlock. And these are all 150 feet or more or so.
Yep.
The watermelon berries. I think that's what people in Alaska were picking and calling watermelon berries.
At the bottom there's a different track, different type of animal track. This one was mink tracks. Last one was raccoon, I think.
It's a pretty trail. Mm-hmm. A little side trail there, huh?
I think that's a log.
Pardon? She's done.
No, she's not done.
Oh.
She's just looking around. Nice of
her. It's very nice. Another big dug for her. That one's probably right about 8 feet in diameter down here, right? 8, 10? What's down there?
Bobcat traps. That's pretty cool.
Huh?
That's pretty cool.
Something out of the jungles.
Yeah.
Expect some old Mayan temples in there.
Yeah.
There's quite a covered old log rotting away with all sorts of plants growing all over it. An old tree, is that right? That actually has grown over an old tree there too, huh? And there's part of the old tree just being hung on to still by the roots of this smaller tree here. That's neat. It lasts for quite a while, huh? Yep. So over 100 years old, that nurse tree they're figuring, perhaps. Unit.
There's the Quinault loop, and then there's the rainforest loop. Mm-hmm. And
that's
so
the roots of a tree butted up there with all the ferns all over, and the tree falling that way.
Out of the lodge, I guess.
All sorts of ferns back over there. Down the wall. And a big cut through a six foot high tree there. What do you got this time?
Bears! They call these things deer fern.
There's been skunk cabbage all over the mid or over the Pacific Northwest here. Every little valley seems to have them.
Now we're down here in the rainforest.
Here's Ray going about 65 down this little road along the Quinault River. She really likes these little roads, scooting along here between the trees. Especially the more roller coastery, the better she likes it.
Populations. And what do you think that is? Haven't talked about yet. a sea star. Yes.
Bella Flint.
The sea star is the keystone species of the tide pool area. They help help maintain balance and find bright purple ones. We've got a maroon one down here. They're, the sea star that we have here is called the ochre sea star. And it's number one species. And they do come in all these different colors, but no one knows why. Down here. But they all are the same species. And they like to eat the most part. A lot. They is what is where their stomach is. And if their stomach is out, it looks like a little jelly marble. This looks like a clear marble. But when they're about to eat a mussel, they grab all these little tubes throughout their body. And the water pressure ends up in their 2 feet. And allows their 2 feet to move around and to be like little suction cups on the rock. A lot of times when sea stars have been out of the water for a long time, you'll see them on the higher rocks hanging on.
Acorn barnacles, really tight. Those are only about 1/4 inch apart. Across the forest.